What's up, gangsters? So here I am on yet another aimless day in my little workshop. I thought that I was about done with the man flu, but apparently not. And as you can hear in my voice, I still very much have the sniffles. So I don't have much mojo for actual work, but I'm really bored. So I just decided to do some more testing. And I have gotten some of these Molotow liquid chrome pins that people have been talking about. And I've seen a couple videos online and, you know, sort of, I think people are getting the idea that this is like a magic bullet, a silver bullet, for producing a chrome finish. And as always, when it comes to all things involving chrome-like paint in model making, I was very skeptical, so I decided to get some, and I've done a little bit of testing, and got some interesting results for you to check out, so let's take a look. All right, let's check these things out. First of all, I've got the 1 millimeter and the 2 millimeter size, and I'll show you the 1 millimeter. You can see that I mean, it's small, but it's not tiny. So doing something like a landing gear oleo cylinder is certainly possible, but you know, that's not a real precise tip. But it is what it is. So let's take a look at the other one. This is the 2 millimeter. And you can see, it's pretty huge. It also comes in a 4 millimeter size, which obviously is really large. Now, the way these things work is you just pump them up and down to prime them until they until they're producing ink. And then they flow, and they really flow. And you'll see that here in a second. I'm going to zoom in. Okay, hopefully I'll be able to do this without totally blocking the camera. Let's see if I can get the right angle here. Yeah, I think you'll be able to see this. Now, this is a pretty glossy surface that I have polished for some other testing with chrome type paints. So I've got a really smooth surface, and I think that's key. But you can see what I mean when I say that they really flow. I mean, I am completely obliterating all of the surface detail there. Now, what I have already learned is that by the time this dries, and it does take a while, an hour, maybe two, I don't know, that it shrinks down pretty well, and it leaves a pretty flat surface. But even if it doesn't, I find that this sort of wrinkly look is, I don't know, it's kind of compelling, because that gives you that sort of oil canning effect that you get with an aluminum skin anyway. So that might not be so bad if it weren't for the main issue that I've found with these things, which is that it's a very fragile finish, and we'll get a chance to take a look at that later after they've dried. But in the meantime, whoops, zooming the wrong way. In the meantime, what I have done, because I want to test this stuff from an airbrush. So, even though I've seen some videos where people have been able to pop the nib out of the end of the pin and then just pour directly into an airbrush cup, before I saw that, I decided to just try this. I just used this little syringe and I stuck the needle directly into that nib and extracted a few mils of the stuff in here. So I'll be able to just squirt that directly into my airbrush cup. So I'm going to go do that now. I'm going to spray that over here in a different part and see what we get, and then we'll come back to it when it's all nice and dry. Okay, so this just got a lot more interesting. The first thing I had to do, obviously, was get the stuff out of the inside of the pin, and that proved to be significantly more difficult and messy than I expected it to be. But, a few splatters of chrome paint on my pants and the floor later, I was able to crack the nut. So, let me show you that first. So, you can see here that I've got the pin grabbed here in my vise. And you can see that it's got threads right here on this part. So, what happens is this whole end of the nub unscrews. Now, before I discovered that, I discovered that the actual nib can be very easily pulled out, but that won't help you much because there is a spring-loaded check valve in there, and you can see that right here with this little part. And this section stays in this section when you unscrew the cap. And I had to pop this out of there with my hobby knife, but I could have probably just grabbed onto it with some pliers or whatever right here. popping it out of there with my hobby knife is the part that resulted in me having a splatter of chrome everywhere, because it went flying. So the first thing I did was dump some of the ink out into this cup, and you can see, I mean, that's pretty cool looking, right? Looks like freaking liquid silver. Let me get some of this stuff out of the way, and I'll show you what I did. First thing I'm going to do is dump the rest of the... I've got this pin pretty well emptied, and I think I'm going to just write it off at this point and call it a sacrifice for the cause of science. They're not cheap. These pins are like $13. But what never occurred to me, and I feel really stupid for that now, is the fact that you can buy refills for the pins, which I'm sure would make getting the stuff into your airbrush cup a whole lot easier. Anyway, this is how we learn, right? We let Rube Goldberg do stupid shit. So, anyway, I'm going to clean it off of my tweezers here. I've discovered that just regular cheapo lacquer thinner cleans it up really well. No problem. Because I did make a mess all over my airbrush in the process of trying this out. But anyway, let me show you the result. This is interesting. Not sure exactly what the conclusion is going to be yet, but check this out. Now, this is still, I really shouldn't be doing this yet, but I'm impatient. This is still not where I feel like I'm gonna touch it. I started off by just spraying this section right here, and I found out pretty quickly that this is the exact opposite of spraying all clad chrome, where you want to sneak up on it and spray really light, thin, translucent layers. You got to go the opposite. You got to just hose this stuff on there, because it will not take the chrome shine until there's enough there that it can kind of flow and create that smooth surface. Now, this is sprayed directly out of the pin, okay? That's just the straight ink, not thinned or anything. And this is the section here where I did it with the pin itself. And you can see that's started to shrink down and dry enough that the rivet detail is starting to show up. But you can see that fingerprint I just made in that section right there. I sprayed this like 10 minutes ago probably, and it's still very definitely sticky. So anyway, I came over here and I sprayed it at full density a few more times just to see what I could do, and you could see I was a little more light-handed, and it came out better. But you can see that any sort of overspray screws it up. So you've got to do your entire surface, and you got to do it wet, and you got to do it in one shot, or you're going to get places where the chrome does not look right. So I did that with the ink at full viscosity out here on this wingtip, and I just blasted it, and you can see that it definitely you lose some detail there, but look at the reflectivity. I mean, that's pretty damn impressive. So then this may be the most important discovery of all. I decided, okay, I'm done. I'm going to clean out my airbrush. And so, hold on a minute. I'll show you this. I blew out the remainder of the full strength ink into my trash cup here, and you can see right there on the side where I did that. And I was pretty impressed by that, because that's obviously a really rough surface, and that proved that you don't have to have the high gloss base that you have to have for like all clad chrome. So then I put some cheapo hardware store lacquer thinner in my airbrush to clean it out. And I started spraying it in this cup, and I expected that it immediately was going to just wreck this and turn it into basically silver paint, because that's what happens with all clad chrome if you get any sort of lacquer near it. Anybody who's tried to do a gloss clear lacquer on top of all clad chrome knows that. Not only did it not completely destroy that when I sprayed, you know, what was basically straight hardware store lacquer thinner on it, but it kept spraying shiny, and I was like, okay, wait a minute. So then I dumped some of the ink out of the cup, and I thinned it about, I don't know, I mean, I just really eyeballed it. Thinned it about 50% with that same cheapo hardware store lacquer thinner. And that's what this is right here. And you can see that it doesn't break up. I don't know what this ink is made of, but whatever's going on there, that full-strength hardware store lacquer thinner did not make it break up like I thought it would. And so then I took that thin mixture, and I came back, and I sprayed that. I sprayed that all over this front section of the wing. And again, I sprayed it wet and continuous there, but you can see that I didn't lose any detail. I mean, that detail's already a little soft from the layers of paint and varnish that are underneath there before, because I've been testing this piece with clear gloss varnishes on it. But I mean, look at that. I mean, that's about as good as I think anybody is going to see from a chrome paint. So what I'm waiting for now is for this to get completely dry, and I'm going to give it plenty of time, because I want to see, how durable it is at that point. And then I'm going to, I expect to find that it's really fragile. And so then what I'm going to do is clear coat it with a water-based acrylic varnish, aqua gloss to be specific, and see what that does. But I'm also going to clear coat it with a, I may try some GX100 or some X22 thinned with Mr. Leveling Thinner, which before this accident I would not have expected to be a good idea. But given that the regular old lacquer thinner didn't cause any issues, it may be possible to clear coat this stuff with something hotter than a water-based clear gloss. So we're going to see what develops with this experiment, but it's already more interesting than I expected it to be. Okay, so let's do the fingerprint test. Actually, I already did it right here. You can probably see that giant fingerprint that I just put on there. I mean, and literally all I did was this touch, and you can see exactly what happens there. Do it again. Touch. I mean, that's as that's the kind of fingerprint that a crime scene investigator has wet dreams about. So, not good. And if you try to wipe it off, you just get turned into that. So definitely not good. This is what I meant about the durability issues with this stuff. Now, right here where I've thinned it with regular lacquer thinner, let's see if it behaves the same way. It's kind of interesting. It's still fingerprints, and it's distinct, but not as bad. And when I wipe it, it also doesn't get quite as destroyed. I mean, it's still not, still doesn't have the same brilliance that it had. Let's take a Q-tip, see what happens when we just try and wipe that fingerprint off with a Q-tip and see if it'll sort of rub out. And it kind of does. It's not not great though, and the Q-tip is definitely messing with the finish, definitely dulling it down. And that's no surprise, because when you look at the Q-tip, you can see that it's coming off on the Q-tip, and that's without much real effort. So that is exactly what I was expecting. Now, in some ways, you know, even that area there that I just burnished with the Q-tip is not necessarily bad. I mean, aluminum has a sort of depth to it, even when it's no longer completely shiny. So that, you know, is not necessarily a deal breaker, but what I'm going to do now is clear coat this with a couple of different things and see how it behaves and how that affects the final appearance. Okay, so here we go. I have sprayed some clear stuff on this, and it was 100% predictable. The first thing I did was spray aqua gloss over here on this, basically from my finger this direction. And it did, you know, it did exactly what I thought it would do, which was, you know, almost nothing other than provide an a clear acrylic shell on there. It doesn't change the reflectivity. In fact, it actually increases it a little bit. And, you know, it's a subtle thing. I personally don't really care for this because it changes the nature of the specularity, the reflectivity, whatever you want to call it, just enough that to me it looks plasticky. And that's why I really don't want to put a gloss clear on top of one of these aluminum paints. But there just may be no other option. I mean, it may be you know, a pretty simple choice between you know, spraying something that's not quite so shiny and not having to clear it. Because one thing I've found in my testing is that the all-clad polished aluminum that I had right here was a lot more durable than the chrome. Whereas the chrome would come right off, the polished aluminum was not as bad. Still not great, but not as bad. So, you know, it's probably going to just come down to being, you know, which is the least of the evils, you know, and kind of go from there. Now, part of the reason for all that is because here you can see where I sprayed some X22 thinned with Mr. Leveling Thinner. And you can see what I mean. As soon as the spray hit that chrome surface, it turned it into basically a bunch of grains of aluminum paint. I think what happens is that all of these pigments are, you know, where it's nice and shiny here, are laying down very flat and well behaved, and then something happens when you put this lacquer-based finish on there that causes them all to just basically float up and go wonky. So, you know, what you have now is basically just a slightly glossy metallic silver, which to me is just, you know, again, doesn't look terrible, but it's just not, it's not worth doing. It's not what I'm looking for. Then I thought, over here, I had this can of Model Master Metallizer Sealer that I've had around for a long time, which, as far as I know, is just a clear gloss lacquer. And I sprayed it right here. And it's not quite dry yet. Close, but not quite dry. But same thing. I mean, look, you know, you can see it leaves a pretty glossy finish. Pretty smooth finish, and again, not terrible, but not what I was after if I wanted that level of a polished look. This looks more like aluminum sheet that's oxidized, but still has some reflectivity, which again, is not necessarily a horrible look. And I think what I'm going to do is experiment maybe with, like, maybe going on top of this with a semi-gloss and see what that looks like. So I don't know. Lots of experimenting yet to do. But that is basically, you know, what I expected to find with this ink. Okay, so there you go. I am not 100% on my conclusion yet. But I'm sort of entertaining the possibility that this stuff may be the best available answer for a real polished aluminum look for a couple of reasons. I think that the end result looks a lot like all-clad chrome. But with a couple of important differences. One, while this stuff is not really very durable, it's a bit more durable than all-clad chrome. Now, that's sort of like saying, would you rather be punched in the face or in the gut? Because neither option is good. They both suck in terms of durability. You can wipe them, either one of them off with your finger, totally screw up the, you know, the polished aluminum look that you get very easily. And obviously, no weathering products are going to be allowed on top of either of them. So, it kind of doesn't make any difference. But I kind of like the way you can paint with this a little bit better, in that it's the total opposite thing from all-clad chrome. Whereas instead of sneaking up with real fine layers, you just blast it on there. You just hose it down. And I found that because of that, it's not nearly as sensitive to the surface prep that you start with. In fact, I'm not even convinced that you have to have black or a glossy surface, because there are a couple of places on my little test piece here that definitely were not super high gloss or black, because I sprayed it over the top of some of the silver paint that I already had on here. So from that perspective, if you can get to about the same place that you can get to all clad chrome without having to go through all the bullshit of spraying a gloss black surface and polishing it before you can ever even lay down the chrome, and then everything you do after that is still the same, to me, that's a better answer. I'm always excited about something that involves less work. So from that perspective, I think this may be a better answer. And I'm gonna tinker with it. It may be expensive. The refills, if you can get them, are pretty expensive. I think quite a bit more expensive than a bottle of all clad chrome. So I'm gonna have to look at that aspect of it. But I have a project coming up. I'm gonna be doing the Edward/Hasegawa F86 for the upcoming Scale Modelers Critique Group 45-day group build. So, and it's going to be an aluminum finish. So, I don't know. We'll see. More experimenting to follow. But anyway, I hope you found this interesting. I tried to give it a little bit more of a thorough look than the stuff I've seen on these pins so far. So, there you go. Anyway, thanks for watching. As always, much love, guys.